Hey, horse people. Okay, so this guy says he put this horse in here, didn't tie him, and allowed the horse to turn around to see if that would help him with his fear. I'm kind of iffy on this because I don't know a lot of information. This horse seems to be extremely nervous and fearful in this trailer. I'm not sure I would do this way. When you lock a horse up and he's scared and you let him work on his fear, I talk about distracting a horse. A horse moves his feet to refocus on something. If you let a horse stand and focus on his fear, it builds and builds, and his just survival instinct just will create him to explode. And, you know, I've got videos where horses have tried to jump out windows of trailers because they were put in there and locked in, and their fear built up so much because they weren't ready. I don't think this horse is ready to be locked in his trailer. So I wouldn't have done this. I don't know the guy that did this. I haven't watched him. Somebody sent me a video, asked what I thought. Let's take a look at it, and I'm going to leave the sound on here and just listen to the horse's fear for a second, and then I'll talk about a few things. Okay, so right away, I'm not a fan of tricking a horse and then locking him in. So he showed him some hay here, some food. The horse looked down and then immediately was like, I got to get out of here. As soon as he saw him leave, he was like, I'm not getting trapped. I was tricked. Tricking horses sometimes works, sometimes it doesn't. I don't like tricking horses with horse trailers. Horse trailers are dangerous situations. They can bump their head. They can try to jump out. They get scared. They can kick. They can kick through the wall. There's a lot of problems that can go on. You have to get a horse to go on a trailer comfortably, easy. It's a process. It's not an event. This is an event. I'm going to sneak a horse in. I'm going to lock him in and leave him there. That's not training the horse. That's forcing the horse to deal with his own fear, and I'm not sure you're helping a horse. So let's take a look a little more. If I had to guess, I would say this horse fell through a trailer before and hurt his leg. Or he keeps checking the floor. Besides, there's plywood on the ground. Hopefully there's something stronger. If that floor is bending or bowing, and a horse feels that, that's going to make him insecure if he's had a bad experience with this before. So again, this horse is just showing the way his ears, they're not pinned back, but they're not forward. They're in this kind of almost a pain or helpless position. And his facial expression, this horse is scared to death. So I'm not sure horses learn a whole bunch when they're scared. So are you really teaching a horse anything in here other than I'm going to sneak you in, I'm going to lock you in, and I'm going to leave you in this scary situation and make you deal with your fear by yourself? That's what I'm not a real fan of about this technique. I mean, the shaking of the head, the ears, this horse is just... all of his behavior is discomfort, unsure, insecurity, confusion, frustration. I mean, there's so many things that this horse is going through. And is there any benefit to making him go through this? I'm not sure. Maybe let him walk in and shut the door for a minute and then open the thing and give him release so he learns that you can be scared a little bit, but I'm going to let you out. And then we're going to go back in. You can be scared, and then I'm going to let you out. So he starts looking to you to relieve this pressure. If you just stand there and let him deal with his pressure on his own, it builds, and then he has to find ways to release his own pressure. And for a horse, that's flight. And if I can't flight, I'm going to try to jump. I'm going to try to kick. I'm going to try to rear. I'm going to do everything that Mother Nature has told me to do when I'm fearful or trapped in order to get away. So I have to try something. And I don't want a horse trying something when he's this scared. I just wouldn't have done this. I mean, that's shaking. That's almost like a fearful tremor. I mean, he's literally just I just feel so bad for this poor horse because he is trying to deal with everything. I don't like the metal snaps. I don't like the metal halter. Those are other issues. I don't like tricking him in with food and then running out and shutting the gate as you leave. I don't like abandoning him in here by himself. If he was standing in there, this horse would be calmer because then he felt like he'd have a herd. He'd have somebody with him. Would it be more dangerous to stand in there with? Yes. That's why I wouldn't have put this thing. I would have walked him in, let him check that, and we both would have walked out and went, okay, you went in, no problem. You walked in, I'm not going to abandon you. I'm not going to trick you. We're going to walk in together, and we'll walk out together. And next time we'll walk in together and relax a little bit, and we'll walk out together. So I would have done this differently. I'm not saying that my way is perfect or the right way. I'm just trying to work to limit or minimize the stress and fear of a horse to where I put a horse, and there's no doubt this guy put this horse in this position, so I don't want my horse thinking, I am going to put you in a position of nothing but fear, and I'm not going to help you. I'm not going to try and help you find an easy way out. I'm not going to help you try and find the right answer. I'm just basically going to abandon you, lock you in there, and make you figure it out on your own. I don't want my horse thinking I'm going to do that to him. And that's what this guy did to him, and I think that's what the horse is learning. Remember, it's not what we want to teach. It's not what we think we taught. It always comes back to what did the horse learn? What was the horse taught? What does the horse think? Because that's the ultimate challenge, and that's the ultimate goal, is to get the horse to think on his own. And if you think like a horse, would you want to learn this way? Would you want somebody tricking you into a fearful situation, then locking you in that fearfulness, and then running out and abandoning you? You wouldn't. And it's not a good way to learn. And it's definitely not a good way for a prey animal that their whole instinct and their whole safety and survival depends on open area and able to use their speed and flight to save themselves. When you take that away, you put a horse in a total different mindset. And it's a dangerous mindset. This horse, poor thing. Now you're going to be able to find situations where people are going to say, well, Rick, sometimes you got to let them figure it out. Sometimes you can't baby them. And you look, I'm not saying baby a horse, but I am saying you can make it easier to learn and you can make the learning experience more pleasurable than force, pain, or fear. If you, every time you teach a horse to learn through force, pain, or fear, and you see every problem as a nail and your only tool is a hammer, that is not a good way to train horses. So you can make this easier and accomplish the same goal. Why wouldn't you? Most people wouldn't, because the easy way is fast and the right way always takes more time, more thought, more knowledge, more giving on your part. So people pick the easy way with horses. The easy way is never the fast way. It's rarely the best way. The slow way is the fast way. Locking this horse in here, to me, is trying to get a fast fix. And it's not the right way because it's fast. A slower way would be more appropriate, in my opinion. I hate seeing little horses scared. Okay, so the guy does what this is called positive reinforcement, is food, whatever. Remember, I talk about the training and conditioning model of training any animal. It's stimulus, response, reward. So whatever you stimulus, you give a word or something, a hand movement or something, you stimulate the behavior you want. When you get the behavior you want, you reward it. So if I stimulate a dog to sit, that's the word I want. The response is he puts his butt on the ground, and then I reward him, either with a pat on the head, a good boy, or I give him a piece of food. This guy is not really following that training module correctly. He's telling this horse, the stimulus is I lock you in here, and I make you scared, and when you shake and pound your foot, I'm going to give you food reward. So he doesn't realize what he's teaching. Now, I do believe that sometimes giving a horse food or letting him eat will relax him and will take away some of his fear. But in this situation, I'm not sure this is appropriately applied. So is this guy wrong? Is he mean? Is he trying to hurt? I just don't agree with his technique. And he may be some great super horse trainer. I don't even know who he is. But he's applying some of the concepts that I agree with by trying to distract the horse from his fear with food. But I think he lost that ability for the horse to learn when a horse is so scared and he's in there shaking. I might have gave him food when he went in there like he did. And if he stood in there with me, with the gate open, then I would give him food while he's standing in there with me. So he learns that when I'm in a horse trailer and I'm with Dad, I get a piece of food. I would be okay with that. I would be okay if he walked him out of the trailer and every time he walked him in, he gave him a little piece of food. So he associates food. I don't think you need to train every horse that way. I don't think a horse needs to be trained that way. But for a special situation where this horse is so fearful, sometimes you have to pull in your toolbox and do different things. Because not every shoe fits every foot, and not every training method fits every horse. And if you only have one training method and you think it works for every horse, you're going to get a couple horses that ain't going to work, and you're going to make the situation worse, you're going to get the horse hurt, or you're going to end up labeling the horse stupid or crazy because your one technique doesn't work. Being a horseman takes years of learning several different techniques, putting a lot of tools in your toolbox, and being able to pull the right tool and try different tools to get the easiest and best response for the horse. That's the key. People want the easiest and best response for them. Which way's faster? Which way's easier? Let me send you off to a trainer. Let me get a bigger bit. Let me put a tie down on. Let me do all these things that are fast and easy for me. And that's never a good way for the horse. So hopefully you get a little out of this. I don't remember how this thing ended up ending. I can speed it up a little bit, kind of move forward maybe. Figure out this. Stands there for a while, shakes. He's eating, he's still scared. He's looking for food. Is he calming down? His ears are a little bit more alert. He's still scared to death of that floor, although he's chewing on the carrot. He goes after the guy for another carrot maybe. Guy's got carrots in his pockets. When does he give the carrot? Is the horse getting the carrot for thinking he's doing something right? Now he abandons the horse. Look at the energy. Look at the fear when he walks away. What this guy did right here, and he doesn't know it, is he created a draw. When he was standing next to him, he was part of the herd. The horse was finding a little bit of comfort and security with him, and when he walked away, did you see the anxiety and the level of fear increase? Like, oh my God, in a horse's mind, I'm in a scary trailer. This thing's going to eat me or kill me or hurt me any second. I don't know how to get out of here, but at least with my herd mate standing next to me, he's in danger too. So maybe I don't need to be as scared as I am, but now my herd mate just abandoned me and ran off. He must know something's going to happen. Oh my God, I got to get out of here now. He created a draw, and if anything, this would cause his horse to try to jump out or kick or rear because his anxiety shot straight up. You never want to intentionally raise a horse's anxiety like that without being able to control the result. I know somebody's going to say, well, Rick, when you sack out a horse and you put a plastic bag, he gets scared at first. He does. But I can control that. I can remove it. I can read him, and I can slowly introduce it, and I can take it away quickly if I see the horse can't handle it. And I control it through rhythm and feel when I'm giving a horse fearful stimulus. You're not controlling anything here. You're locking a horse in, and he's got to figure it out for himself. I don't think that's a good move. I don't think it helps the horse. I don't think it gets good results. Will it work? Maybe. Can it work? Maybe. I don't like doing things with maybes with horses because the horse ends up paying when it doesn't work. He gets hurt. He gets suffered. He gets traumatized. He has to pay for everything that I do. And that's called responsible horsemanship. Taking care of your horse. All right, hopefully you got something out of that. We'll end that there. I know I went long, and hopefully you got something out of it.